this fall. Prepare for an extraordinary event unlike any the world has ever seen.
Oh, it's going to be much, much bigger than that.
The only people who don't want to disclose the truth are people with something to hide. The only people who don't want to disclose the truth are people with something to hide.
Hello, YouTube. Well, it looks like we got a whole bunch of bombs up there. Well, this just doesn't look right at all. I don't know what we're going to do here, people. Them people just doing whatever the hell they want to up there. No matter what they say, what they do, they just do anything they want constantly. I mean, we say no, they say yeah. We vote for Ron Paul, and they keep giving us Romney. We don't want Romney, we want Ron Paul. Good news about that today, it looks like he's won Iowa and Minnesota, which is a good thing. Come back, I'm going to show you a little bit of this clip of this video right here. I don't know. It's off the chain. This guy's talking like nobody cares about anything. I mean, I get people in here that tell me that I don't love my country because I'm doing this. People, y'all ought to be ashamed of yourselves. Telling things like the Nazis doing this and the Nazis done that. Well, you better think about what them Nazis really did do. Them Nazis did a whole lot of stuff. I mean a whole lot of stuff. Y'all hold on and listen to that, some of this.
Now, what do we got to do? Because let's be, and Sarah's right. People's intimidation on this issue is not defined by just Republicans. There are Democrats intimidated by this issue. Wrongly, but intimidated, and they think their politics and their community is such that they can't do this. The truth is, what we need again to get moving on this legislation is put together a crime strategy like we had before, which is why we passed the bill today on the cops, putting money back into putting police officers on there, getting voices for change, and then making sure that we have a president, I cannot put my partisanship aside, a Democratic president who will take that office and use it to protect the streets and the kids that grow up on those streets and make sure that we once again have an assault weapon ban, a Brady...
Hello, people. I had to stop it right there for a minute and say something. I used to be a Democrat, but the only reason why I changed it is so I could vote for Ron Paul. Democrat used to mean vote for the working man, but it ain't for the working man no more. It's for the best interest, just like the Republican Party. The Republicans and the Democrats are one entity. They're the same. They're a corporation together. They do the same. Get that through y'all's head, that this man, what he just spoke, is a bunch of shit. That was a campaign speech. He wants Obama to win. People, wake up. Smell the roses. Go on and listen to the rest.
Bill with the full force of the law out of land, because we need somebody in the Oval Office that moves this Congress. We had an election about change. People are clear about the special interest. The right thing to take into the election, and it's the right policy. If you're on that no-fly list, your access to the right to bear arms is canceled because you're not part of the American family. You don't deserve that right. There is no right for you if you're on that perilous list. That should be number one in what we do. Make sure there's a full force of the law behind the Brady Bill. So to all those who dedicate their lives to seeing sensible gun laws, remember, sensible gun laws, police on the beat, giving our kids an alternative to that street, and making sure that we have the drug laws so people, because those are the types of people who are most access to most violent types of crimes. Once the COPS program ended, once we let those gun laws ban.
Okay. I can't play the whole thing. I don't want to get in trouble with copyright infringement. Fair use. We used a lot of it. But anyway, the gist of it is he wants you to be banned from being able to buy a weapon. This been screwed up, folks. Like everything else they've done so far, it's got additive things in it, just like all the other ones. They're going after the Second Amendment, people, as hard as they can go. That's your right to bear arms. I don't know about y'all people, but this is screwed up. I'm going to take you over here to this little site right here. So hold on here a second. I'm going to get it set up. Okay, here we are. There you go. Read it in a week, people. Look at this. Look at this. Maze. Four? I mean, come on, folks. How long is it going to take y'all to wake up? This is just damn right. All you people that are out there bought guns in the last few years, they're going after you, people. You're scared of what your economy is doing because you want to protect yourself. But no, you can't protect yourself. They want to be your protector. Why your wife or your daughter is getting raped over there in the corner. They're over there cussing at you, but your buddy over there raping your daughter or your wife or your grandmother. And y'all think that's right. Come on, people. This is just damn right disgusting. I mean, this is disgusting. People, we got to wake up. Y'all gonna have to start calling your congressmen and senators, and you gonna have to start putting some laws down. Cause evidently they ain't getting a message. Not at all. Hello everybody. I'm back again with something else that's disturbing me. It's already a proven fact that this guy was pretty much set up. And, you know, it is his word against his wife's word. Ex-wife, that is. And I don't know if any of y'all ever been through a divorce before, but they come up with some really, really crazy shit. And if they got help to push the situation, they can damn sure make it real nasty. But some of these comments on here are, you know, pretty damn bad. And, you know, you get your own thought, but then you want to put all Oath Keepers and the Tea Partiers in the same party. You know, I'm not going to show you all of them, but here's just a few. But, you know, enough's enough. You don't like the guy, okay. We see that you don't like him. 23 dislikes. 49 likes. 49 people. More people like him than dislike him. And know the situation and know what's going on. So before y'all get out there and judge people, which y'all do quite frequently, people, go the hell up a little bit, okay? Do a little bit more research. find out a little bit more about somebody. You know, want to crucify everybody you see. Well, if you want to crucify somebody, why don't you crucify the people that need crucifying? And quit crucifying that man for no reason. Like all these guys here. Look at all that. Every one of them guys need to be crucified. That guy was fighting for your rights. And they crucifying him. And now y'all want to get in there and say all these crazy things, and then you got this right here. You got this right here. While you're bothering with that, trying to get people's attention off of things by trying to argue with people. And then you got this. Then you got this. It's right here in your face. Don't you just love this? It's just right here in your face. I mean, it ain't nothing to it. It's just in your face.
Okay, everybody. We're over here on the blog now. And got this linked up for you. And it's good news. If it pays off in the end, it's great news. For those Ron Paul lovers that are out there, that draws crowds like Obama did in the last election. They just assume that Romney's winning everything. Well, now, is he? I just don't know. According to this lady on Fox News, maybe not. Might be a good thing. The way it's going, maybe it's a great thing. I don't know. We'll have to sit here and kind of check it out and see what happens here.
At this time tomorrow, we will be getting in results from the very, very, very anticlimactic Republican presidential primaries in Connecticut, Delaware, New York, Pennsylvania, and Rhode Island. There is precisely no one on the edge of a seat anywhere in America breathlessly awaiting the results of those primaries, because the Republican nomination appears to be all but sewn up. Even with Mitt Romney having all but sewn it up, though, there do continue to be little off-script moments on the Republican side, things that run counter to the prevailing sense we have that the Republican primary is stick a fork in it done. Por ejemplo, Newt Gingrich today kicking off a 10-city tour. So if the main idea here, the main script everybody's reading from here, is that Mitt Romney has got it done, it is over, frankly, there are still things going on the Republican side that make it seem like it's not done, at least not totally done. Perhaps the most off-script thing that has just happened on the Republican side is that I think Ron Paul just won Iowa. Seriously, this weekend. You'll recall that the Iowa caucuses on the Republican side this year were a bit of a disaster. Remember what the counting was like that night in January?
The numbers we're receiving from the state do not match the numbers we just received from the county chairwoman right here in Clinton County. If these are the final numbers...
The numbers don't match.
Well, I'll explain it to you. John, you go ahead and explain it.
The numbers, Madam Chairwoman, I'm not questioning your numbers. I'm saying the numbers you're giving us now do not match the numbers that the state central committee has reported so far from your county. And they say one precinct is missing. So if your numbers are that missing precinct, and these are the final numbers from Clinton County, excuse my scribble, but 437, not 386, 354, not 321. We can stop right there. Well, that would make
Romney the winner.
And then about 20 minutes after that strange middle of the night moment on CNN, this guy, the state Republican Party chairman in Iowa, officially declared that Mitt Romney had won Iowa. They officially declared Mitt Romney the winner by eight votes out of more than 120,000 cast.
Congratulations to Governor Mitt Romney, winner of the 2012 Iowa caucuses. Congratulations to Senator Santorum for a very close second place finish in an excellent race here.
Don't believe him for a second. About 2 weeks after that, the party released final certified results that said that Mitt Romney was not the winner. The Iowa State Republican Party had changed its mind. They said first there was no way to know who won, then that the results should be viewed as a tie, and then they said that actually Rick Santorum had won.
It is indisputable
that the certified caucus results have Rick Santorum winning by 34 votes.
So declaring this, then, a victory for Rick Santorum.
Yeah, the certified vote results.
Now, you sure know? After all of that, after the disastrous vote counting and the disorganization and the chaos and Romney winning and then Santorum winning, the Iowa Republican Party chairman resigned, naturally. And now, 16 weeks after the voting happened and Mitt Romney was declared the winner, and 14 weeks after Rick Santorum was declared the winner, now it appears that Ron Paul is the winner in Iowa. See, Iowa gets to send a total of 28 delegates to the national convention in Tampa this summer. One of the delegate seats goes to the new state party chairman who replaced the guy who was the disaster who quit. The new guy is an avowed Ron Paul supporter, so that's one Ron Paul delegate. This weekend, the state nomination committee that picks 13 more of the delegates, that committee was taken over by a majority of Ron Paul supporters, which means Ron Paul has just locked up at least half of Iowa's delegates. These 13 plus 14 in the form of the state party chairman, 14 of the 28 delegates, half the delegates are his. He will not get less than half. So Ron Paul either wins Iowa or, worst case scenario, he ties for first place. And while we're on the subject, looks like Ron Paul just won Minnesota too. Minnesota has 40 delegates total. This weekend, Ron Paul won 20 of them. Now, not all the rest of Minnesota's 40 delegates have been allocated yet, but with half of them locked up, Ron Paul cannot come in worse than first.
Okay, everybody. You see my point here, right? Look at the crowd. You ain't never seen a crowd like that with Romney. Never. Gingrich or Santorum, they're all real small. They've been cheating you, people. They've been cheating you. Just like the congressman in the Senate House, they're doing the same thing. They're cheating you, people. They're cheating you. They're cheating you. They're cheating me. They're cheating themselves because they don't really understand what's really going on. This is bad. Real bad. You can come here on this blog and you can look at all the videos that are here. And there's several other links over on the right-hand side of the blog where you can see more of these videos where it shows where they've been cheating, the vote's been cheated, the whole thing. It just goes on and on and on. So please, people, do your magic. Look at it. Work on it. Get it going. Here's more links for y'all. And all of you guys that down here at the bottom, appreciate y'all for coming and linking up and blogging in. And feel free, people, if you want to reblog them, please do so. Because that's what makes this stuff work. If we don't reblog, if we don't blog, reblog, whatever, it just don't work. They're blocking people out left and right. We got to get something going. And one other thing. I'm going to take you to this one here. And I definitely don't want y'all to forget about this. Don't forget this. It's been a little sluggish right now. Don't forget to go to this one and view this one as well. I'm not going to go real slow. I'm just going to go through it. But there's multitudes of videos explaining it, what's going on, different things happening. It tells you the court case, the whole thing that mainstream media will not touch. So y'all go there and look. Here's the three videos of the courtroom. Right here. Here's another one of the sheriff, the cold case posse. Thanks again, folks, for linking it up. You can go on past, and there's more than just this one. Somebody else put something on there. I don't know what. So many videos, and then you got to go to the old. There'll be more videos here. So y'all take your time, go through them all. There's several more videos. There's one here, this one, that one, and that one. So y'all go see them all, folks. There's a lot of stuff going on in this country that everybody needs to know what's going on. If you don't know, then you really, I'm gonna be quite honest with you, if you don't know what's going on, you really don't have no right to open your mouth. And I don't mean that in a disrespected way. If you don't know what's going on in your country, then you don't have no right to say nothing, because all you care about is what's getting on your table. If you're getting something on your table, you're okay. Well, that ain't what's cutting it in this country right now. You need to get up, smell the roses, and start paying real close attention, or you're not going to have a country. Not one that you know as being a country. You might have a Nazi camp somewhere, or a FEMA camp, or something you might be living in and think you've got good sliced bread or something. But folks, I'm really upset about that bill. I mean, this right here is just, I ain't got the words not to get mad here. This is just, I mean, this is just like the NDA bill. In fact, it's worse. So now half your rights are gone. Again, on something, on another bill. See, half your First Amendment's gone. Now half of your Second Amendment's gone. Three quarters of your Fourth Amendment is gone. And it just goes on and on and on. And what makes it even worse is this man right here is not even, he's not even really eligible to be who he is. His own attorney admits his birth certificate is a fraud that's on the internet, that he brainwashed y'all into believing that was real. And they're not pressing charges. Why? Why ain't somebody pressing charges? Why ain't somebody trying to put this man in prison for all of the false things that he's done to our country? Don't y'all understand? This has got to stop. Don't y'all understand that we can't even get the message out through mainstream media because they're scared. We can't get the message out through people, our friends, because they're scared. They'll only handle one thing and that's it. They won't even push the message. Some of them. Some of them will. Some of them won't even push the message because they're scared. Why are they scared? I'm going to be quite honest with you. We're going to go over here to Alex Jones' channel. And anymore on his channel, I mean, about the only thing he's got, like this one right here. We'll go to this one. I mean, I've been noticing this for the last week, and I don't mean it any disrespect to Alex, but generally with something like this, there's generally a video connected to it. Maybe it's not one that he, there's may not be one out there for that. I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying on a general rule anymore, this is about what you get. And sometimes you don't even get a photo. I'm sure he's got permission to do so, but everything he does anymore, he has to have strict permission to do everything he does. I mean, he was talking about fair use in one of his videos that I watched today that he put out yesterday. I mean, this stuff is getting ridiculous, people. We can't even, before long, and this ain't no lie, you're going to have to pay 50 cents for a piece of toilet paper to wipe your ass with. And then you're going to have to pay 27 cents to pay tax on it to flush it down the toilet.
not counting the turd that went in, it's going to probably cost you 75 cents for the turd that goes down. These people are out for every damn dime you got, people. Every damn dime. They're trying to destroy this country, and they're doing a damn good job, and a lot of you people out there are still sleeping and letting it happen. This is ridiculous. You don't have no First Amendment no more. You can't protest in front of any federal building anymore. Why? Because the occupiers was protesting? People, don't you understand that the Jesse Ventura videos that come out, like the one with the FEMA camp, all of them things, all of those videos have a lot of meaning about what's going on? I mean, don't you understand? The ones of you that hadn't seen it, it's on my channel. Go see it. It's in full version, or it's in 15 or I think it's 15-minute clips. Watch the 15-minute clip or watch the whole thing. It doesn't matter which way you do it. Just go to the channel and watch it. You can come over to my channel. I ain't got it fixed in the right direction, but you can come over here. Come over to my channel. Go down on the right side, which you can't see. But go down and say view all under the playlist. And then go down to FEMA camps. There you go. There's Jesse Ventura. That's the 15 minute with the first top three. Or you can come down here to this one. This is the full version. It's 44 minutes and 39 seconds. They're all here. All the videos are here. All of them. Come and watch them. There's a lot of them in here that are great things about all of this. And if you want to watch two of them at a time, this one right here has got the FEMA camp. The FEMA camp and the oil spill, the Gulf oil spill. You can watch that one. You can watch them all. They're all here. I got them. I say all. All of them, but maybe a couple. I did miss a few. I tried to get them all, but I missed a few. So, people, much love to y'all. Heads up. And for God's sakes, all you people out there that got big channels, huge channels, get this message out so people can wake up. And, you know, we got a lot of stuff going on in this country that people need to know. And, you know, these three right here, these three videos right here, explain a lot to you. And the first link, let's just go to this video. I'm going to show you. The video, you see the name. Well, you can't see the name. You saw the name on the other one. You go to this one right here, the second one down. It takes you directly to the blog where it's got all the videos. You don't even have to watch the video. Go to the blog and read the whole story, everything about it. Everything. It's all here. It tells you everything that went on in that case, and it needs to get out. And it, be quite honest with you, it's not doing that much. And it ain't because it's not getting out. It's because people are blocking it. I'm being blocked. We already know. I mean, I've explained that before. I mean, it's a proven fact. It's being blocked. So people, please help a brother out by getting the damn message out. And you guys that's got big channels, reblog this. You got a big channel and got a blog too, reblog it. Repost it. Repost the video with the links in it. Or put it on your kick out and kick it out through your friends. All the way, every way you know how. It's good information. It's information that people need to know. It ain't just about things that we don't need to know. I blog everybody. Everybody that's got good stuff, I blog it. If it's truthful and I know that it's true, I look it up. I check it out. If it's true, I'm going to use it. I'm gonna push the information. You know, people, you know I do. I got 4 channels and I got this blog and I got my hands full. I can't just constantly do this and not, it don't go nowhere. I mean, it's a waste of my damn time. Yeah, and I'm going to get these comments, well, you're not that good. Well, fuck you. I don't see you doing any damn thing but getting in there saying you ain't worth the shit. And you don't explain this and you don't. I'm explaining it. If you go to the fucking blog and read it, it's there. It's all here. Go there and read it. Or do you rather just watch it? You don't do no research. You just want to see what you're losing. What a dumbass. Grow the fuck up. Pay attention. Get the message out. Heads up, people. Much love. I'm sorry I got a little outraged, but damn it, this is pissing me off.